Welcome to all. Let us see the forces. Forces, definition of forces, action of one body on another, characteristic by its point of application, magnitude, the line of action and the sense. For the definition of forces, experimental evidence shows that the combined effect of two forces may be represented by a single resultant force. Resultant force is equivalent to the diagonal of a parallelogram which contains the two forces in adjacent legs, which can be written as P plus Q, which is equivalent to R. Here R is the resultant and P plus Q are the forces. Forces is a vector quantity. Vector means parameter possessing a magnitude and a direction which add according to a parallelogram law. For example, displacement, velocities, accelerations. Scalar means parameter possessing magnitude but not a direction. For example, mass, volume and temperature. Vectors are classified into five types. First one is fixed or bound. Fixed or bounded vectors have well-defined points of applications that cannot be changed without affecting an analysis. Next one is free vectors. Free vectors may be freely moved in space without changing their effect on an analysis. Sliding vectors may be applied anywhere along their lines of action without affecting an analysis. Equal vectors that have a same magnitude and direction. Negative vectors of a given vector has the same magnitude and the opposite directions. So we can add two vectors by using a trapezoidal rule and a triangular rule. First, let us apply the law of cosines, which is r square is equal to p square plus q square minus t 2pq cos b, where r is a resultant that can be written as p plus q. Law of sine states that sine A divided by Q, sine B divided by R and sine C is divided by A. Vector addition is a commutative, that is P plus Q is equal to Q plus P. Vector, we can subtract the vectors also. Addition of three or more vectors through repeated application of a triangle rule. The polygon rule for the additions of three or more vectors. Vector addition is associatives, that is P plus Q plus S, which is equal to P plus Q plus S, P plus Q plus S. This vector is also multiplicative. Resultant of a several concurrent forces. Concurrent forces, set of forces which all passes through the same point. A set of concurrent forces applied to a particle may be replaced by a single resultant force, which is the vector sum of the applied forces. Vector forces component, two forces or more forces vector which together have a same effect as a single force vectors. For a sample problem, the two forces acting on a board at A determine their resultant. We can determine by using a graphical and a trigonometrical solution. First, graphical. Construct a parallelogram with sides in the same direction as P and Q and length in the propositions. Graphically evaluate the resultant, which is equivalent in direction and proportional in magnitude to the diagonal. Thus, a parallelogram with sides equal to P and Q is drawn to scale. The magnitude and direction of the resultant or the diagonal to a parallelogram is measured as resultant is equal to 98 N and alpha is equal to 35 degree. Trigonometric solution. Applying a triangular rule from the law of cosines, R is equal to P square plus Q square minus 2PQ cos B. That is 40N the whole square plus 60N the whole square minus 2 into 40N 60N cos 155 degree, which where the resultant is 97.73 N. From the law of cosines, sin A divided by Q is equal to sin B divided by R. Sin A is equal to sin B into Q divided by R. Sin 155 degree into 60N divided by 97.73 N. A is equal to 50.04 and alpha is equal to 20 degree plus A's, where alpha is equal to 35.04 degree. Thank you.